Hello, my dear children. The topic of the day is electromagnetic wave. In this very chapter, we are going to study nature of light. Children, this very chapter is introductory chapter of optics. Throughout optics, we study various aspects of light, various phenomena associated with lights, various optical instruments associated with light. So before we study every aspect of light, we must know how exactly is light. So what is nature of light? That is the first point we are going to discuss. Well, as far as nature of light is concerned, we believe that the light has a dual nature. What is this dual nature? Well, light has two different natures. One is called particle-like nature, other is called wave-like nature. This particle-like nature was put forth by Newton through his very famous Newton's corpuscular theory. But this theory was rejected because it could not explain the refraction of light from a denser to rarer medium. Well, it was Huygens who proposed the wave nature of light then and there. There was controversy in between these two natures. The whole scientific community was divided into two groups of scientists. One group believed in particle nature, other believed in wave nature. But later on, by the stupendous work of de Broglie, the compromise was brought about. And from then onward, we believe that the light has dual nature. It behaves both particle-like as well as wave-like. When we say light as wave-like, we call light as electromagnetic wave. That is the name of the chapter. So electromagnetic wave explains the wave-like nature of light. Well, as obvious from the name itself, light and electromagnetic wave consist of what? Electric field vector as well as magnetic field vector. Both these vectors are perpendicular to each other, and at the same time they are perpendicular to direction of propagation of wave. That I am writing here in short form as DOPOW. So in electromagnetic wave, electric field vector, magnetic field vector and direction of propagation of wave, all three are mutually perpendicular to each other. The situation is like this. This is, say, x-axis, the direction of propagation of wave. Then these two fingers, which are perpendicular to each other, they are what? Electric field and magnetic field vector. If electric field vector at any instant is along y-axis, magnetic field vector along z-axis, then x-axis is going to be the direction of propagation of wave. So E, B and direction of propagation of wave, DOPOW, all three are mutually perpendicular to each other. Electric field vector, which constitute electromagnetic wave, and magnetic field vector, well, both these vectors vibrate perpendicular to DOPOW. That means electric field vector vibrates like this, up and down, perpendicular to DOPOW. Magnetic field vector also vibrates, along z-axis, perpendicular to DOPOW. So both the vectors are perpendicular to each other and they vibrate in the direction perpendicular to direction of propagation of wave. That is why this light wave is also called as transverse wave. So this vibration perpendicular to DOPOW explains their transverse nature. Well, to understand further wave nature of light, we have to recapitulate the concept of wave mechanics we studied last year in class 11. And what we studied last year, we studied progressive wave in one dimension. Well, in progressive wave, which was mathematically written as y is equal to a sine of omega t, this y is the displacement of the particles of the medium or particles of the wave. Well, So y is the instantaneous displacement. A is the displacement amplitude. This quantity omega is angular frequency, which is 2 pi by t or 2 pi into nu. This t is time period of oscillation. Nu is linear frequency. And this quantity k is called as angular wave number, which is 2 pi by lambda. And 1 upon lambda is linear wave number. This whole quantity in the bracket omega t minus kx is called as phase. So in progressive wave, what vibrates simple harmonically perpendicular to direction of propagation of wave? What vibrates is displacement. There is displacement of the particles of the medium perpendicular to dopant, perpendicular to direction of propagation of wave. And this vibration is simple harmonic. So is the vibration of electric field vector and magnetic field vector in electromagnetic wave. Well, we plot wave with the wave is graphically plotted like this. We have already studied this last year. Well, this is from here to here, this is called one wave. This is displacement axis, and this axis represents x, the distance covered by the wave. This is called as path. This axis also represents time t, and this axis also represents theta, which is called phase, the angular displacement of the particles of the medium. And if we mark these axes, we can mark this axis in term of all three quantities. Since this distance is this is one complete wave, therefore the distance from here to here is called as wavelength. This is one wave and this is length of the wave. What do we call this as? Wavelength. So if we mark this axis in term of lambda, what do we get? This is zero, this is lambda, distance from here to here is lambda by 2, this is lambda by 4, this is 3 lambda by 4, this is lambda one wave, and thereafter it is 5 lambda by 4. If we mark this axis in term of phase, that is the angular displacement, it is 0, this is pi by 2, this is pi, this is 3 pi by 2, this is 2 pi, this is 5 pi by 2, and so on. And if we mark this axis in term of time, then this is going to be what? 0 time. This at this particular instant the time is t by 4, at this particular instant the time is t by 2, 3 t by 4 here, t, and then 5 t by 4, and so on. Now as this wave progresses through the medium along say x-axis, well, at each and every point in the medium, we have a distinct value of what? Time. Like time here is 0, time here is what? T. So at each and every point, we have a distinct value of time. If at this particular point, we have time, value of time as T, then at this particular point, say, the value of time is going to have some other value. And that some other value is what? That some other value is T plus, say, dt. T plus dt. So what is this dt? This dt is the time difference between these two points. Like at each and every point we have a distinct value of time. Same way, at each and every point in the medium, wave covers a different distance, different path. If at this point value of path is what? X. Then at this particular point the value of path is going to be what? X plus some additional path dx. And this dx is what? The path difference between these two points. Well, if at this point the value of phase is theta, then at this point, well, we will have the phase as what? Theta plus some additional phase, d theta. At each and every point, we have a distinct value of phase. So the phase difference between these two points is, say, d theta. Well, if we look at this one complete wave, what is path difference between these two points? Path difference between these two points is what? Lambda. What is phase difference between these two points? Phase difference between these two points is 2 pi minus 0 is what? 2 pi. And what is time difference between these two points? Time difference between these two points is what? T minus 0 is what? T. These three are entirely different quantities. But 2 pi phase difference correspond to lambda path difference, and lambda path difference correspond to what? T time difference. So all three quantities, they correspond to each other. They are not equal, they correspond to each other like this. So any arbitrary value of phase difference, d theta, is going to correspond to dx path difference and time difference dt. So what is the relationship between this phase difference dx d theta, path difference dx and time difference dt? Like 2 pi phase difference correspond to lambda path difference, it correspond to t time difference. Same way, let us say d theta phase difference correspond to dx path difference and dt time difference. The relationship between all three quantities what? Just divide the two. D theta upon 2 pi is equal to dx upon lambda. So this is the relationship between what? Phase difference and path difference. Now let us look at these four terms. Let us divide the two. Dx by lambda is equal to dt by capital T. This is the relationship between what? Path difference and time difference. And look, let us equate the first two terms with these two terms. D theta by 2 pi is equal to dt by t. So this is phase difference, this is time difference. The relationship between all the three quantities are written like this. So children, these were some very basic results related with wave mechanics. So all these results are used here when we discuss the wave-like nature of light, that is electromagnetic wave. Well, this displacement vector here is replaced by what? Electric field vector. In electromagnetic wave, this displacement vector is replaced by electric field vector as well as magnetic field vector. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to draw a still photograph of electromagnetic wave. So if this is your positive x-axis, which is your Dobrov direction of propagation of wave, this is your positive y-axis, this is positive z-axis. At any instant, if electric field vectors are like this, if these are electric field vectors, this is the loop of electric field vectors. Electric field vectors are vibrating where? Yeah, they are vibrating along y-axis, and of course they are what? Perpendicular to direction of propagation of wave. These are electric field vectors of electromagnetic wave. So displacement is replaced by electric field vector. What is this electric field vector? See, this electric field vector is mathematically going to be written as E is equal to E naught sine of omega t minus kx. And remember, this E is where? Along y-axis. So this is instantaneous displacement y, which is replaced by electric field vector. This is maximum value of electric field vector, and this is sine of omega t minus kx. X is the direction of propagation of wave. So this is electric field vector of electromagnetic wave, and the loop of electric field vector at any instant is right before you. Where is loop of magnetic field vector? See, the loop of electric field vector, this is a still photograph. Just remember, this is a still photograph of electromagnetic wave, and in this still photograph, electric field vectors are in xy plane. They are where? They are in xy plane. This is in xy plane. This is xy plane. Now, where is magnetic field vector? Magnetic field vectors vibrate along z axis perpendicular to Dobrov. So the loop of magnetic field vector is, yeah, it is along z axis, and it is like this. It is like this. Yeah, this is 3D situation. These are B vector along Z axis. This was E vector along X axis. This is B vector along Z axis. This is 3D situation. You have to visualize this. And these magnetic field vectors are where? They are in ZX or XZ plane. XZ plane. So the situation is what? If this is the loop, this is the loop of electric field vector in vertical plane, then the loop of magnetic field vector is what? In horizontal plane. This is Z axis, this is Y axis, and this is X axis. So electric field vector loop is formed like this. This is half the loop. As half the loop of electric field vector is formed in this xy plane, simultaneously half the loop of magnetic field vector is formed where? in XZ plane. This is X axis, this is Z axis, XZ plane. As the other half of the electric field vector, other half loop is formed like this, then other half of the loop of magnetic field vector is formed like this. So magnetic field vectors, the loop is formed like this in this horizontal plane. Electric field vector is formed, the loop of electric field vector is in what? Vertical plane. And the loop of magnetic field vector is what? In the horizontal plane. I presume that you are getting it. So this is 3D situation. And if we mathematically write down the value of electric field intensity at an instant, then it is going to be what? Bz is equal to what? B naught sine of omega t minus kx. And both these vectors together represents what? Electromagnetic wave, electromagnetic EMT wave. So this is still photograph of electromagnetic wave. What is moving situation of electromagnetic wave, we'll study in the next class. So for the time being, this is all for the day. We'll continue this in the very next lecture. The topic is not yet over. Thank you very much, and God bless you all.